Hi guys, I'm alive, barely. Wow, yeah, that food poisoning took a bit of getting over, but I'm all better now. I'm fine. Harris and Rob have headed back to Brussels, so I mean, it was just incredible to see them. It was a really amazing time. You can catch up on our road trip around Rwanda here, somewhere around here. Yeah, we had a really good time, and it's great being back, but I've kind of suddenly hit this wall of creativity because I sort of thought, after filming the tiki boat on Lake Kivu and Nyungwe Forest and the waterfalls, what do I talk about now? So I bumped into my friend Jo the other day, and she said, "You know what? It'd be really good if you did some more really specific videos about living in Kigali. Things that help people out on a day-to-day basis, like the Momo video I did, which a lot of people have been watching because Momo is quite a complicated system, and it was one of the first videos I did was, how do you use this mobile money system on your phone when you come to Rwanda? So you can probably see that somewhere around here as well, or in the links below. So today I thought I would do possibly the most specific video I can think of, which maybe only I need to know the answer to. But I hope not. I assume that if I need to know the answer to it, somebody else probably needs to know the answer to it as well. And that is, where do you find bin bags? So quite a while back, I did a video about recycling in Kigali, because there was this sudden big recycling drive where loads of households got these two bags. You got a green bag for recyclables, and you got a blue bag for stuff that you can't recycle. And you filled those up and you put them out on bin day for me Friday. And I was doing that, and then my bags went missing and I couldn't do it anymore. And my neighbour managed to find me a couple more bags, but they went missing. So then I reverted to just using black bin liners, which at the time you could find in any shop. And shortly after I did that video, they disappeared. So now I can't find black plastic bin liners anywhere in any of the shops I used to buy them from. So maybe the powers that be were watching that video and they went, "Oh yes, black plastic bin liners. Those are plastic bags, and technically we banned those in 2008. So, maybe we should just get rid of those." So, I mean, it's great for the environment that they're no longer available, but it's a real headache if you're living in a household with rubbish, which I guess we all have, and occasionally you need to get rid of that rubbish. And in order to do that, you need to put it in something. I used to use like plastic shopping bags. No. So it's hard to explain. Plastic, those thin plastic like polythene bags are banned, but you get like plastic bags for life, which are made out of a thicker type of plastic, which you're supposed to be able to use, continuously. So I was using those to put stuff out, because at the moment I put all of my rubbish into the paper bags that you get when you go shopping, because I have loads of them. But then I need to put them into something else, because if you just put them out and it rains, they turn to mush, they're easy to knock over, and the content spills all over the street. So I was putting them into these bigger plastic shopping bags. But the people who take the rubbish away are supposed to throw those bags back over the gate so that you can reuse them. And just as with my recycling bags, they didn't do that. So I've just totally run out of bags to put rubbish in. So I was sort of sitting there going, well, what do I do? What is the next step here? How do you put your rubbish out when you don't have any rubbish bags? And thankfully, my friend Laura of Bugisera Nurseries, which is another fantastic video, she sent me the contact for a place called AgroPlast. And these guys are really interesting, because what they do is they take throwaway plastic and they recycle it into plastic bags. So they sell large, medium, and small plastic bags in black, red, green, and even though it's not on their list, they also sell it in blue. So I contacted them and they said, yeah, sure. You know, they're like the big ones are only like about 500 francs, so 50 cents a bag. So I've ordered two green bags to put my recycling in, two blue bags to put my non-recycling in, and two black bags in case all of the other bags disappear and that's the only thing I've got left. So I'm going out to collect those today. They're based in Gahanga, which is the industrial park zone, which is quite a way away. So I'm going to hop on my bike, I'm going to go and get the plastic bags, and then hopefully I can put my rubbish out on Friday, which will be really helpful. So I'm going to put a link to everything below, so if you, like me, have run out of bin bags in Kigali, you can go and order some more. Hi guys, I'm back. That was absolutely crazy. I videoed my ride out there, so I'm going to post that separately because it was a little bit hair-raising in places. But I did in fact find AgroPlast. And the guy there, Jean-Claude, was so lovely. He actually showed me around the factory. And what they do is they collect up the recycling. So, you know, when you put your green bag out or your recycling outside, on whatever day you do that, somebody comes and picks it up and they sort through it and they send the plastic to places like AgroPlast. And they also pay street cleaners around the country to bring them plastic. And they use like the polythene kind of plastic. They melt that down and they're recycling that into not just bin bags, but also into, what do you call it? Like a tubing and plastic for things like polytunnels and agriculture, hence AgroPlast, agroplastic. You get the idea. So that was incredible to see. And they've also got a whole pile of plastic bottles at the back of the yard, which they can't use because you can only melt down like the polythene plastic. I think, I don't know the technical terms, I'm not scientific on this at all, but you can only melt down a certain type of plastic bag to make plastic bags. But plastic bottles, they're opening a new plant soon that is going to make that into plastic road bricks. So I guess instead of cobblestones and tarmac, they're going to try making roads out of plastic bricks. Now there is actually, I saw on YouTube a while ago, I think it's somewhere either in, I'm going to go with Kenya, where a lady's already doing that. She has a factory where she's building plastic bricks for road surfacing and path surfacing and, you know, walking paths. Sorry, I'm absolutely knackered. That was a bit of a crazy ride. But anyway, I've made it back with my bags. And here is what I got. So I opted for the extra large size. Extra large, and I got two green for recycling, two blue, and two black. And they're actually huge. I think I've gone for the slightly bigger than I needed size because I wasn't too sure what big, medium and large was. But that's absolutely perfect. And I'm going to maybe just write my like street number on that as well or something in the hopes that they bring it back. What do you think, Jazz? You impressed? I'm impressed. You impressed? You're not. What are you doing? What are you doing? Who knows? Do not put your claws through this, otherwise I will have to put you in a plastic bag and put you out on Friday. so yeah, these, I mean, they're big, they're huge, they're great, they're fantastic. So now I'm going to go and collect up all of the little paper parcels of rubbish that have been accumulating around my house and put them in a plastic bag and put them out on a Friday. And let's see whether or not the bin men give me my bags back. Forget about cat in a hat, it's cat in a bag.